Hello guys, we are going to show to you guys the situation in the clinical presentation and then correlating this with the bitewing radiographs. Okay, so pretty much a video for us to understand the presentations of caries, and we are going to take advantage of the technology of intraoral scans, as digital dentistry is one of the focus of this YouTube channel. And you guys will see that the zoom of the intraoral scan, which is actually a digital impression of the patient, will allow us to see properly how those crowns were, how these teeth actually were in the clinical situation. Now we are just showing here to you guys the caries detection. So this is the caries detection from three shape, from the Trios 5, the intraoral scanner that we are using here in this video. And it's actually an interesting tool which is under ongoing research. Without further ado, let's analyze some cases, and we have here the first one. So we have these molars and we have the bitewings. So this is the upper right quadrant of the patient. And here you guys have, so let's focus for the moment on the upper teeth of the patient. So of course you guys are realizing that the premolar is superimposed to the molar, because this second premolar is actually palatal in relation to the first molar, okay? If you guys don't remember these concepts, when I say anterior to this, palatal to that, medial to that, lateral to this, please go back to my video of dental terminology, okay? I will add the link here on the top right corner of this screen. If you guys don't remember how to detect caries, occlusal caries and interproximal caries, I will also add both links here on the top right corner of this screen during this video, okay? So the link will show up here at some point. We also need to understand that changes in the dentin, we need always to compare the radiopacity of the dentin, okay, in relation to areas that are more radiolucent, okay? And don't forget that clinical presentations of the tooth will be the gold standard for occlusal caries. So what is the gold standard assessment method for occlusal caries? The clinical assessment, okay, the ICDAS classification. Why it's very important to understand about the ICDAS classification? Because we can differentiate initial from moderate from, you know, extensive lesions. One thing that I feel it's very important for you guys to know is that the threshold between dentin involvement and only enamel involvement is the ICDAS 3 and 4. Okay, so basically until ICDAS 3, you have not dentin involvement, okay? And then even there is even an article here that proved that we can use sealants on lesions ICDAS 3, okay? I'm adding this reference. Okay, so here we have the reference. This is a very nice article, which is a randomized clinical trial. And basically they got satisfactory clinical results treating ICDAS 3 lesions with sealants in a 2-year follow-up, okay? So even in a 2-year follow-up, the results were still very good, which is a very important finding in the literature. So from ICDAS 4, then you would have the dentin involvement, the dark shadows with enamel breakdown or not, and ICDAS 5 and 6, you would have the cavities, all right? And then, of course, you guys know that we need to restore. If endo is needed, if there is pulp chamber involvement, then of course you would treat the endo or extract the tooth, depending on the severity of the lesion. So let me now remove this reference and let's see these lesions, okay? So this is the one of the sides. Now we have the other side of the patient of this intraoral scan. And then again, we can see that we have differences here in the brightness of the, you know, of the occlusal surface of the molar. There is even, you know, a dark spot here in the fissure, which we can't see in the bitewings, but of course, this is still not non-reversible caries. If you guys don't think that we can say reversible and non-reversible caries, well, those are actually accepted concepts in the field of preventive dentistry. So we have here, you know, alterations of the enamel, okay? So this enamel is radiolucent, but there's no dentin involvement, so those would be treated as initial, okay? Because we are here just focusing on the upper teeth, all right? Now, let's see the lowers now of these patients. So now we are checking the lowers, okay? And you guys are seeing that we do have occlusal caries, okay? So we have occlusal caries. There's even the shadow underneath, and We are seeing this actually in the radiograph, okay, for this deciduous tooth. But of course, you guys are realizing that the clinical examination is the gold standard, okay? But we can see that, you know, even in a higher magnification, that the radiopacity is altered in that place, all right? So this is really interesting, okay? Now we are even seeing, take a look at these fissures of the molar, okay? And now the other side, all right? So you guys can always pause the video as much as you want, but I'm going to show to you guys in details. Here we have this mesial lesion, okay? So the mesial lesion, even with tooth wear, there is a cavity, and of course, this is detectable because the enamel and dentin are affected, okay? Enamel and dentin are affected. Very good, so now we have this, the other molar, all right? Which is fine. So we are seeing now just the presentation of this molar, okay? But it's not the one in this radiograph. All right, so case two, we have here case two. And now we are seeing that we have initial caries between those two molars, okay? And of course, this is interproximal caries. You cannot see in the clinical examination, you know, most of the times. But all right, so it's not in the dentin, so this could be treated as initial. And okay, so now, and then we have this tooth with tooth wear and this very big restoration, okay? And that's the clinical presentation of this tooth. All right, so just for you guys to correlate with the radiograph. Okay, now you do have occlusal caries. Take a look at this dentin, all right? And you guys can see that we have cavitations, we have caries, okay? So we have caries, and this is the presentation. Okay, so another nice tooth for us to correlate with the radiograph. The bitewing was not the best one, but we can actually see, you know, the situation of this tooth, and the adjacent is also broken. All right, so now we have this old restoration as well with tooth wear, and take a look at this situation here, okay? Even with initial caries, all right? Even with initial interproximal caries, okay? The dentin is also, all right, with this radiopacity that is not completely normal, let's say. All right, and then we have these changes in the radiopacity. Okay, and for the other side, then of course we have this crown. Okay, so this is the crown, the metallic crown that you guys are seeing here, and then the restoration, the resin restoration of this tooth, and you guys are seeing a radiolucent line below the restoration. But if the line is regular, then this could just be a lining material or just the thickness of the bone material. When you put too much bone, then you would see this line and it could be normal, okay? So another tooth for us to assess together. All right, so now case three, and then you guys are seeing on the radiographs and then on the clinical presentation, you know, a very nice occlusal caries, all right? So occlusal caries are on your screen, all right? This is the upper of the patient, right? So those two occlusal caries as well, we can see here. So even the upper, okay, we can see the occlusal caries very nicely on the distal aspects of this teeth. And let's go for the other side. And then, of course, you guys are realizing that we have caries. We can see the cavitation here, but okay, let me move this. But the bitewing, this bitewing is not good at all right? Let's go then for case four, and then you guys are seeing fissures, okay, stained, but then of course we need to assess with the radiographs as well, right? So let me move this, and now we are seeing some changes in the occlusal surface, but it's not actually too bad. All right, so again, initial lesions almost affecting the dentin. Actually, this is affecting the dentin, all right, in the upper teeth, and in the lower teeth, we have also interproximal alterations here, okay? This is the presentation of the teeth, all right? And now we are giving a zoom, so we could just monitor this situation, all right? So now just a case, you know, this last case for us to check together. So you guys are seeing this premolar with those two metallic restorations, a buccal restoration and a occlusal distal restoration. Okay, and then with the horizontal bone loss, the distal horizontal bone loss, and then you guys would see even the cavitated tooth that is adjacent to the second premolar, so basically the first premolar. All right, Well, if you guys like, please hit the like button. Please give the answers of the ICDAS classification of all these teeth in the comments, and see you guys on the next videos.